Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. This is biology session. Cell, the basic unit of life. So we have completed the lesson. So today in this video, let us discuss the questions which are appeared in the previous Olympiads. It's a very important lesson. Let's have a brief review. The basic structural and functional unit of an organism is called a cell. Okay? Cells are like bricks that are assembled to make a building. Similarly, cells are assembled to make the body of every organism. That's why cells are considered as basic structural units of all living organisms. Okay. Cells are first discovered by Robert Hooke through a simple magnifying device. Presently, due to the presence of high power microscope, study of the cell and its components become very easy task. Cells consist of different shapes, and size, and they vary in number depending on the organism. Unicellular organism consisting of only single cell, example amoeba, paramecium, bacteria, okay? Whereas multicellular organisms like plants and animals, they contain number of cells, okay? There are three basic components of the cell. What are they? Plasma membrane, nucleus, and cytoplasm. Plasma membrane provides the shape to the cell and helps in transfer of substances between inside and outside of the cell. It surrounds the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like substance. It contains various cell organelles. Okay? This is the nucleus which controls all the activities of the cell. There are two laws of the plant cell differs from animal cell. Plant cell differs from animal cell in some aspects. The plant cell contains colored plastids, which is absent in animal cells. There is only single large size vacuole in the plant cells. Whereas in animals, numerous small vacuoles are present, like food vacuoles and contractile vacuoles. Okay, the discovery of the cell, if you take, in 1665, Robert Hooke discovered the cell. Okay, in the cork tissue. He called as it honeycomb, each one compartment called as cell. Based on the number of cells, organisms are classified into unicellular and multicellular. Then cell theory was elaborated by a German botanist Schleiden and a zoologist Schwann. According to cell theory, all organisms are made up of one or more cells and the products of those cells. All cells carry out life activities like energy production, growth, and increase in size, like that. The new cells arise from the pre-existing cells. These are the three main components or the three main statements of cell theory. So cell membrane, it gives the shape and structure. It is present both in plants and animals. Okay, in plants additionally, cell wall is present. Okay. Next, unicellular organisms, example bacteria, protozoa, yeast. Multicellular organisms, human beings, plants, animals. A tissue, cells divide to form the tissue. A group of specialized cells made up for a specific task is called a tissue. Variation in the shape. The cells show wide variations in the terms of shape. A particular shape of the cell facilitates a particular function. Okay? Structure and shape is related to its function. Amoeba is a unicellular organism, but it is irregular in shape. The shape of amoeba keeps on changing because of the formation of pseudopodia. Similarly, WBC also irregular in shape. The cells are generally round, spherical or elongated shape. For example, muscle cells, spindle shape. Whereas RBC cells, biconcave or and round. Next, cells of striated muscles, they are cylindrical in shape and very long. Nerve cell appears like a star. Okay? Nerve cell appears like a star. Like this. Okay? Next, prokaryotes. What are prokaryotes? The organisms with primitive nucleus are called prokaryotes. Example, bacteria, blue-green algae are the examples of prokaryotes. There, the genetic material is not organized by nuclear membrane. Eukaryotes means well-developed nucleus is present. The genetic material are organized in the form of nucleus covered by two layers of membrane. Eukaryotes, example, animals, plants, fungi. Parts of cell, if you take cell membrane, it is semi-permeable in nature. It allows the selected materials to pass through it. It is made up of proteins and lipids. Cell wall. Cell wall is present in the plant cells and in bacteria and fungi. It is composed of cellulose mainly in plants. And additional substances are present in the other types of cell walls. Means in fungi and in bacteria, peptidoglycans are present. Okay, fungi, different materials it is made up of. Cytoplasm. It is a jelly-like substance present between the cell and the nucleus. Different cell organelles are present in the cytoplasm. Nucleus. Nucleus is a spherical structure which is present inside the cell and at the center of the cell. Nucleus controls all the functions of a cell. Vacuole. Vacuoles are very large and conspicuous in plant cells, but a very small in the animal cells. Vacuoles may be absent in most of the animal cells. Plastids. Plastid is an important cell organelle. It is found in the plant cells only. These plastids are green in color, which contain chlorophyll and performs photosynthesis. Mitochondria. They are present both in plant and animal cells, involves in the oxidation of digested food and release energy. Hence, the mitochondria are called powerhouse of the cell. Golgi complex. These are tubular organelles involved in secretion of proteins. Then, ribosomes. They are globular cell organelles involved in the protein synthesis. See, nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. Golgi complex, ribosomes, then mitochondria, then lysosomes, etc. Let us go for worksheet. Are you ready, children? Which part of the following sets contain unicellular organisms only? Amoeba, onion, yeast, Euglena, Chlorella, Escherichia. Euglena, yeast, onion, rhizopus, amoeba, and solanum. Solanum tuberosum. So it is Euglena, Chlorella, and Escherichia. Escherichia is a bacteria, Chlorella is unicellular algae, then Euglena. Which of the following statements is correct about plant cells? They either do not possess vacuoles, or the vacuoles are very small. They have channels between cells that allow strands of cytoplasm to pass from cell to cell. They develop turgor pressure when water enters the nucleus from the cytoplasm, they do not have cell-to-cell junctions like animal cells. Which is the correct? So they have channels between cell to cell, strands. Okay? Which one? Plant cells. So if you see a plant cell, for example, it is an octagon shape here, and this cell is connected to another cell with the help of plasma desmata, the structure. So like this, cell to cell, there is a connection. Okay? Next, read the given statements and select the correct option. Statement 1. Fungi are typical eukaryotic plant cells with exception. Statement 2. All their membranes are achlorophyllous. Okay? So I have to select the statement. Both the statement 1 and 2 are true, and the statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Both statements 1 and 2 are true, but statement 2 is not the correct explanation of statement 1. Statement 1 is true and statement 2 is false. Both statements 1 and 2 are false. So here, once again, go for statement. Fungi are the typical eukaryotic plant cell with exception. Yes. All their membranes are achlorophyllous, means chlorophyllous. Chlorophyll is absent. So that's why they are called non-green plants, because cell wall is present. So both the statements are correct, and statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Which of the following is not a characteristic of eukaryotic plant cell? Endoplasmic reticulum associated with nuclear envelope, centrosomes with centrioles, thylakoids inside the chloroplast, ribosomes associated with ribosomes associated with endoplasmic reticulum. Not a characteristic feature of a eukaryotic plant cell. So that is centrosomes and centrioles. Centrioles are absent in the plant cell. They are present in the animal cell. What is the one major difference between human skin cell and a human egg cell? The egg cell has twice as many chromosomes as the skin cell. The egg cell has half as many chromosomes as the skin cell. The skin cell has no genetic information in its chromosomes. Only the egg cell has a nucleus. So here, the egg cell is a gamete, okay, female gamete. So it is produced of meiosis. The daughter cells of meiosis process exactly half the number of chromosomes of the parent cell. So here, egg cell has half as many chromosomes as the skin cell. Skin cell undergo mitosis, whereas the egg cell, which is formed as a result of meiosis, so it possesses half. Gametes are haploid, somatic cells are diploid in nature. Diploid means two sets of chromosomes are present. Okay? So, skin cell is a vegetative cell, egg cell is a reproductive cell. So, egg cell has half as many chromosomes as the skin cell. Plant cells can usually be distinguished from animal cells because only plant cells possess mitochondria and lysosomes, chloroplast and cell wall, chromosomes and lysosomes, chloroplast and Golgi complex. Okay? Plant cells possess a chloroplast and a cell wall. Next, read the given statements and select the correct option. The number of cells in a multicellular organism is inversely proportional to the size of the body. All the cells in the biological world are of the same size. So here, if you analyze the statement, first statement, okay. But second statement is not giving the correct explanation of the statement 1. So both the statements are true, But statement 2 is not the correct explanation of statement 1. Which of the following is not true about cells? Cells do not live forever. New cells are produced to replace the old cells, which die, as well as for the growth of the organism. If the size of an organism is bigger, the size of its cell is also bigger. The different types of cells have different functions. Here, we have to select the statement which is not true. Which is not true. So, cells do not live forever. Okay, this is correct. The new cells are produced to replace. Okay, this is also correct. And if the size of an organism is bigger, the the size of its cell is also bigger. So this is wrong. Different types of cells have different functions. Okay, the wrong statement is this. Because the size of organism depends upon the number of cells, not the size of the cell. Match the following and select the correct option from the quotes given below. So here two columns are given. The term for component present in the cytoplasm, the living substance in the cell, this is necessary for photosynthesis, empty structure in the cytoplasm, a group of cells. It is a column 1 and column 2, organelle, protoplasm, chlorophyll, tissues, organs, vacuole. Okay, first we need to match so that we can select the code. A, the term for the component present in the cytoplasm. It is organelles. The living substance, protoplasm. This is necessary for photosynthesis, chlorophyll. The empty structure in cytoplasm. That is vacuole. A group of cells, tissues. Okay. Now you have to select. So it is A1, B2, C3, D6 and E4. Correct the given statement by replacing the underlined words and select the correct option. The viscous fluid present in the nucleus is called cytoplasm. Vacuoles are rod-shaped structures which oxidize food to provide energy. Mitochondria contain green pigment, chlorophyll, and take part in photosynthesis. Lysosomes take part in synthesis of proteins. All these statements are wrong. Okay? We have to select the right ones. The first one is, the viscous fluid present in the nucleus is called nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm. Next, vacuoles are the rod-shaped structures which oxidize. It is not vacuoles, it is the mitochondria are rod-shaped structures which perform photosynthesis. Mitochondria contain green pigment. It is not mitochondria. It is the chloroplast. Chloroplast. Lysosomes are take part in the protein. This is also wrong. Actually, ribosomes. Okay. You have to select that option with all these correct. Okay. First one is nucleoplasm. Okay. Next, mitochondria. Next, chloroplast and ribosome. So, option C is the right one. This type of questions are called analytical approach type. We need to analyze the question. In a biology lecture, the teacher was dictating the organelle of a cell as endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleus, ribosome, centriole, and centrosome. Which cell was she referring? Okay. What are given? Organelles, endoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, nucleus, ribosome, centriole, and centrosome. So, the teacher referring prokaryotic cell, plant cell, animal cell. It is not possible to predict from the given data. It is an animal cell, clearly we can predict because centriole and centrosome. Okay. Give the correct order of the procedures listed below to prepare a specimen for microscopic examination. Okay. So, what is the procedure steps? Embedding, rehydration, dehydration, mounting, fixation, staining, sectioning. Embedding, dehydration, rehydration, mounting, fixation, staining, and sectioning. Next, fixation, dehydration, embedding, sectioning, staining, mounting, rehydration. Last one, fixation, dehydration, embedding, sectioning, rehydration, staining, mounting. Okay, actually mounting is done in the last. Okay, so the option D, first fixation, then dehydration, then embedding, then sectioning, then rehydration, staining and mounting. This is actually in preparation of a slide, microscopic examination for. You are given two microscopic slides containing sample muscle test cells from a mouse and from a whale. What will you observe? The whale cells are larger than the mouse cells. The mouse cells are larger than the whale cells. The cells are of different colors. The cells are of similar sizes. Interesting question. Both are animal cells. Okay. Sample muscle cells. So the cells are similar sizes. Okay. Because the surface area is same. Which of the following statements is incorrect? Cell wall is a simple, it is a semi-permeable membrane which allows only certain selective substances to pass through it. Endoplasmic reticulum helps in transport of substances within the cell. Mitochondria carry out the function of cellular respiration. Vacuole helps in osmoregulation. You have to select the incorrect statement. Cell wall is semi-permeable. It is impermeable, rigid. So it is an incorrect statement. Endoplasmic reticulum helps in the transport of substance, okay. Mitochondria carry out the functions of cellular respiration, okay. Vacuole absorbs the excess of fluids, so help in osmoregulation, okay. So here the answer is, incorrect statement is A. Which of the following is not a characteristic of eukaryotic plant cell? Annuli associated with the nuclear envelope, centrosomes with centrioles, thylakoid inside the chloroplast, ribosomes associated with endoplasmic reticulum. Here, second statement is, okay, we have to select a not characteristic feature of eukaryotic plant cell. Ribosomes associated with endoplasmic reticulum means rough endoplasmic reticulum. Thylakoids, chloroplast, okay. Annuli associated with the nuclear envelope, yes. Read the given statement and select the correct option. Fungi are typical eukaryotic cell. All the membranes are achlorophyllous. Already we have. Okay. So here both statement 1 and 2 are correct. Okay. And the statement 2 is the correct explanation of statement 1. Next, match the following. Select the correct option from the codes given below. Ribosome, lysosome, endoplasmic reticulum, cytoplasm, mitochondria. These are the options in the column 1. The option in the column 2, jelly-like substance, powerhouse of cell, site of protein synthesis, transporting tubules, suicide bags. Ribosomes, first let us match. Ribosomes are the sites of protein synthesis. Lysosomes are called the suicidal bags of the cell. Endoplasmic reticulum, transporting tubules. Cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance. And mitochondria, powerhouse of the cell. Okay, A3, B4. A3, B5, C4, D1 and E2. So it is the option A. Okay. Next, what is one likely function of a centriole? To hold the fibers of spindle, to send messages to the nucleus to divide or to divide the cytoplasm, to cause the chromosomes to become shorter and thicker. What is the function of centriole? Centriole no doubt helps in cell division. So it holds the fibers of spindle is the main function of centriole. Which of the following statement is or true regarding the cell structure? Nucleoplasm and cytoplasm together make up the protoplasm. Chloroplast are the type of plastids which occur in the plant cells. In many multicellular organisms, cells have projections called as cilia and flagella. Cell destruction occurs by centrosomes. So here, true statements we have to select. Nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm together from the protoplasm, okay, true. Chloroplasts are the green plastids which control or which occurs in the plant cells, okay. In multicellular organisms, cells have projections flagella, this is also correct. And the cell destruction occurs in centrosome. This is lysosome actually. Okay. So 1, 2 and 3 are correct. True. Which figure shows a human cell correctly labeled? Okay. So here the diagram and options you have to go through keenly. Nuclear membrane, vacuole, organelle, cell membrane, nucleus, cytoplasm. Okay, here vacuole, it is wrongly mentioned. Okay, and nucleus wrongly mentioned. Labeling parts you check. Okay, here next nuclear envelope, okay, nucleus, okay. Here organelles, cytoplasm is wrongly mentioned, vacuole is wrongly mentioned, cell membrane is wrongly mentioned. Here nuclear membrane, okay, nucleus, okay. Organelles, okay. Organelles means more than one. 1, 2, 3 are mentioned here. Okay. Next, cell membrane also correct. Here, vacuole is also correct only. Cytoplasm also correct. In option C, all are correct too. In option D, nuclear membrane correct. Cytoplasm wrong. Organelles correct, here organelles correct, nuclear membrane correct, cell membrane correct, cytoplasm correct, here cell membrane correct, nucleus wrong, vacuole also wrong. Okay, so here the correct labeling part of human cell is C. look at the given cell carefully, identify the function of the part marked Y. This is a plant cell. So what is it marked Y? Let us see. It controls the movement of the materials in and out of the cell. It controls all the activities of the cell. It contains many cell parts. It provides protection to the cell. Okay, by the image here, it is a cell wall. Okay, what is the main function of a cell wall? It provides a protection to the cell. Which of the following is incorrect about the given A and B? A is amoeba, B is paramecium. Both are unicellular and eukaryotic organisms. A is unicellular, B is multicellular organism. Both are capable of independent existence. Both B and C. Here, incorrect. Which of the following is incorrect about the figure? Remaining all correct only. Both are unicellular and eukaryotic organisms. This is correct. Then A is unicellular and B is multicellular. This is wrong. Both are capable of independent existence. Okay. B and C. Also wrong. Here, this is the wrong statement, which is not true statement. Okay. Next, refer the given figure and select the incorrect option. So, seems to be like a plant cell because large vacuole is present. P represents the vacuole. Okay. Okay, let us see the options what are given here, P, Q, R. The part P is found in a plant cell only. The part Q is green color plastid. And the part labeled R is controlling center, okay, nucleus. The part labeled R gets its shape from part labeled P. Okay. Once again, go for the figure. P, Q, R. So here P representing vacuole, R representing nucleus, Q representing chloroplast. Totally a plant cell. Okay, so we have to select what we have to select? Incorrect option, which is not correct. So let us go for option. The part labeled P is found in the plant cell only. Okay, vacuole, large vacuole is present only, plant cell, correct. Next, here only plant cell means in animals also it is present, no? So it is wrong. Next, the part Q is green colored plastid. Okay. Next, the part labeled R is controlling center. It is also correct. And the statement 4, the part labeled R gets its shape from P. That is wrong. From vacuole, they get chloroplasts. No. Okay. So this is also wrong. So here, which are wrong? 1 and 4. Which of the following is incorrect about the given figures? Amoeba, paramecium, both are unicellular eukaryotic organisms. A is unicellular and B is multicellular. Both are capable of independent existence. Both B and C. So here, this is the incorrect about the figure given here. Okay, these are a few questions which appeared in the previous Olympiad. There are many questions, possibility is there from this lesson. Most important lesson. Cell, the basic unit of life. Okay. So please visit our website www.cellbasicunit.com. aimstoday.in. For other information regarding online classes, quizzes, live worksheet, activities, English classes, coding, etc. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel. Press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.